First is XOR operator. Okay. For example, four. Or seven. Shift enter. So we get three. And when you can guess how it is work. Yeah, guys.
Difference?
No, not difference. Okay. Give you next example. Yeah. Tell me. So it's addition, right? Okay. So no issue. I tell you how the XOR operation is working in Python. It's same as XOR gate. Yeah. We have two input, A, B, and output is Y. Both input is zero. One input is zero. Second is one. First is one. Second is zero, both input is one. Okay, then we get output like both input is zero, then we get zero. First input is zero, second is one, then we get one. And next is first input is one, second is zero, then we get one. And both input is one, then we get zero. Okay, so my operands is A. 4 and 7. So first of all, we have to convert the 4 into a binary number as well as 7 as a binary number. Okay. So I am again type binary table 1, 2, 4, and 8. Okay. Number is 4. So 4 and 0, 0, 0. Got it, guys? So there is a binary form of 4. Next is 7. 7. 4, 2, 6, or 1, 7. 1, 1, and 1, and 0. So it's 7. Okay. So when first input is 0, second is 1. First input is 0, second is 1, then we get 1. So the output is 1. Okay. Next is first input is 0. First input is again 0, second is 1. Then again we get. We get one. Yeah, we get one. Then both input is one, like one, one. So one, one, we get zero. So in this case, we get zero. Okay. The next is both input is zero. Then we get zero. So we get zero. So my binary is zero, zero, one, and 1. Then my table is 1, 2, 4, and 8. The answer is 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So got it, guys? 3.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, I give you next example, 8 and 5. Again, 1, 2, 4, and 8. So first operand is 8. 1, 0, 0, 0. Next is 5. 4 or 1, 5. 1, 0, and 1, and 0. So this is 8, and this is 5. Okay. So first input is 0, second is 1. First input is 0, second is 1, then we get 1. Both input is 0. Both input is 0, this case. So we get 0, like this. And first input is 0, like this, and second is 1, like this, and we get one. So we write one. Next is first input is one, next is zero. So first input is one, next is zero, then we get one. So the output is 1101, and binary form is 1248. The answer is 8 plus 13. The answer is 13. So now it's clear how the XOR operation is work in Python.
Yes,
any doubt, guys, till now? Okay.
No, sir.
So let's go ahead and understand the binary ones complement. How to find the ones complement? Okay. So just type a heading. Ones complement. Okay. The symbol is this. Right. 6 and that's enter, and we get 7. Yeah. Tell me, guys, how it is work. Anyone? How the ones complement work? Like we enter 6, but the output is coming like -7. And again, I give you next example like 8. And again, we get -9. And next is we enter like 6. -6, we get 5. Guys, tell me how it is work. Just try, guys. Because you see the pattern. When you enter 6, then we get -7. And we enter 8, then we get output like -9. So you see any pattern on these two examples?
-1.
-1. So is the ones complement is same as minus times x plus 1. So it's right or not? Yeah, guys.
Yes.
Right. So the complement is same as minus times x plus 1. Then x is 6. So we just type 6, for example, 6 complement, okay? So it's same as minus times x plus 1. And x is 6. So the answer is 6 plus 1. So the answer is, yeah. Answer is -7. Got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next is my 8's complement. Okay. I'm just clearing these all things. -8. So it's same as minus times 8 plus 1. And we get -9. Okay. And next is -6. Complement of -6. Okay. So again, the formula remains same. X plus 1. Yeah. The main plus difference, what the main difference is, in this case, x is. Yeah, right.
-6.
So I'm type just -6 plus 1. 1 and equal to -5. -5, then this minus and this minus cancel out. And we get 5. So you see. So got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next question for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And yeah, guys, tell me output. What is the output coming from this statement? 5 times complement and 5.
Minus 6.
Minus 6. Okay. Next.
Minus
6. Okay. What about others?
Minus 6.
Minus 6, sir.
Minus 6. Okay. Next. Yes. Yes, guys. Okay, so I'm just press shift enter and we get minus 6. So I think you got it how the ones complement work. Okay, but I am again resolve this how the ones complement work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 5. So firstly you have to solve the first complement. Okay, so it's same as minus times 5 plus 1 and is equal to minus 6. Okay, so now we have only three operators, 4. Okay, and my x is minus 6. Okay, then again you find the complement of minus 6. Okay, so minus and minus 6 and plus 1. The output is minus 1 and plus 1, minus 5, then minus minus cancel out and we get 5. Got it? So next is 5. Okay, so again we have to find the complement of 5. So 5 complement is same as minus times 5 plus 1, so we get minus 6. Okay, so now guys, now I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have to find the complement of minus 6. Okay. So minus 6 is same as minus times and minus 6 plus 1. So it returns minus 6 plus 1 minus 5, then minus minus cancel out, again returns 5. Then again we have to find the complement of 5. The complement of 5 is same as minus 6. Minus 6. So the final answer is minus 6. Got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Now everything is clear till now?
Yes, sir.
So today I am going to teach you the next topic, list. So list is a structured data type. So list are very similar to arrays. So you know what is array? Anyone? What is array?
Group of logically related data items.
Group of logically related data items. Okay. Others?
Well-defined log data.
Well-defined log data. Okay. Others?
It's a continuous homogeneous elements.
Yeah.
Collection of homogeneous elements.
Okay. So basically, array is the collection of similar type of data stored linearly and called by the same name. Okay, but the list is too different from array. In an array, we have to store the same type of data stored in the array. But in the list, we have to store different type of data, like it's a string and a floating variable as integer, numbers, and some others. Okay, so basically, list and they can
contain and yeah. roll number. Students and the roll number.
Yes, yes, yes. So they can contain any type of variable, okay, like string and floating variable, something like that. And list can also be iterated over in the very simple manner. And I give you one example how to create a list. Okay, so I'm creating a one list like a equal to square bracket. So press shift enter. And we see the type of this variable a. Okay, so type of a. So you see the type of a is list. So got it? What is the syntax of list? How to create empty list? So guys, this is an empty list. Okay, we don't enter any element on this particular list. Got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
So now I am creating a list using different data types. So like b equal to hello and 3 and like python and floating variable like 45.67 and integer again 6. Press enter. Can print B. So see, this is the list. Okay, so we entered different type of variable, sorry, different type of data types. So this is a string and this is an integer and this is a, again a string and is a floating variable and is a integer. Okay, so next thing is we have to already cover the how to get the indexing of the any element. Okay, so now tell me how to get the third variable of this list. Like I'm to fetching the Python in this list. So tell me guys, how can I do that?
वो जो दवाई दी थी ना उनको की.
Yeah. Repeat again. Print. L2, okay, yeah, it's right. Others, yeah, guys, tell me it's right or not.
Right, sir.
So now we have to fetch the Python string in the entire list. So B and using indexing. Okay, so indexing is starting from 0, so 0, 1 and 2. So we just type 2, press enter. You'll see we fetch the Python string in this entire list. Okay, then again we have to fetch any other elements like floating variable. So 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Again, we can fetch another variable like 0. Okay, so got it, guys? How to fetch the any element present in the list using indexing? Yeah, guys.
So please do explain again, sir.
Okay. Okay. My motive is to find the element in the entire list using indexing. So you know, indexing is starting from 0. Okay. So hello contains a 0 index and 3 available on 1 index and Python is available on 2 index. So we have to just type v2, so and press shift enter, then we get python string. Okay, then again we have to run this v3, so 3 is indexing. Okay, so 0 1 2 3, then we get 45.67 as a floating variable. Okay, then again we have to fetch the first element of the entire list like hello. Okay, so we just type 0. So because the indexing is starting from the 0, the first element is hello, and the hello, the indexing of the hello string is 0. So we just type hello and pass the indexing of the particular element 0, then we get hello. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So next is perform some list operation. List operations. Okay. So first operation is AND. Basically, append is used to add an element at the end of the list. So basically, append is a method which is used to add an element at the end of the list. Okay. So now I am creating a list AA equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and press shift enter, then I want to add a new element in the end of the list. So a dot append, and we pass any variable, floating variable as well as string, any other type of variable. So we just pass 6. Okay, press enter, and now I'm printing the list. You see, thus next element is added on the end of the list. Got it? So append method is used to basically add the element end of the list. So you see the my list is ending at 5, but now the list is ended at 6. Okay, so again I have to add a new element, append. Now I'm adding a string. Okay, string. So now you see the string is added at the last of the end of this entire list. So got it, guys, how the append method is work?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any other doubt regarding this append function?
No, sir.
Okay. So now I want to add a next list in the end of this entire list. Okay. So I am adding a new list on the end of this list. Okay. For example, I am creating a next list BB equal to. Okay. Now I am passing this on the append method. And so I'm passing a list, okay, like 6, 7, 8, and 9, and sorry, spelling mistake. You see, we add a new list at the end of the entire list. Okay, so got it, guys, how to add a another list into the entire list AA. Okay, so we had a lot of thing like list, sets, tuples, anything. So next operation is clear. Clearly, basically used to remove all the elements from the list. Removes all the elements from the list. Okay. So I'm just perform this operation AA dot clear. Yeah. Nothing has happened. Guys, tell me. What is outcome is coming from this statement?
All the elements get cleared from the list.
Yeah, repeat again.
All the elements are cleared from the list.
Replaced or placed?
Cleared.
Okay, cleared. Yeah. All right. So you see, we get the empty list. So got it, guys, how the clear function is work. So it's remove the all element present in your entire list. Okay. Now, next method is copy. So copy method is basically used to return a copy of the list. So it returns a copy of the list. Again, I am creating a next list like AB equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And then perform a copy operation. A dot copy and assign in another variable BB. Okay. Yeah. So tell me, guys, what is coming from this statement when I press shift enter? What is the outcome is coming from this BB statement? Yeah, guys.
I think he missed B in the line. Yeah,
tell me.
Copy in A.
One by one. Yeah.
A, B, yeah, copy Arun, in B, B, B.
I think you missed writing B in the sentence.
Yeah, right. All right. So I'm press shift enter. So, sorry. So A, B.
Yeah, I was thinking that.
Got it, guys? So how to copy a next any list into another list. So now B is a list, again a list. So we have to check the data type of the BB. Type of BB. You see the list. Okay. And
hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, please tell again. Repeat again.
Sorry. Okay.
Please repeat again.
Okay. So I am performing a copy operation, how to copy any list into another variable. So now I am creating a list AB equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So now I am trying to copy this list into another variable. So now I am performing the copy operation like AB.copy and assign in another variable like BB. So I am printing BB, then we get output same as like AB. Okay. So this is a copy form of AB. Then I'm trying to find the type of the BB, and you see the type of BB is again the same as list. Okay. Sorry guys, actually I am forgetting one operation, like in this bitwise operation, like membership operation. Okay. So sorry guys, I'm just completing this membership operation. Okay. Membership operation. So I am creating a variable A equal to Python and membership operation is in or not in. So we have to print, find the element is present in the entire string or not. So we have to check like py in A. You see py is available in the variable A. Okay, so when the particular element is present in the entire string, then it's written true. And when the element is not present in your entire string, then it returns. Yeah, guys.
False.
Yeah, it returns false. So again, I am checking this in A. So now you see it returns false. This is a membership operation. Okay, we have to check element present in the list as well as the string in any other type, any other data type like tuples and any dictionary and any others like sets. Okay, so basically you used to check the element is available on the particular element list or not. Okay, So next is not in operation, not in operation. So again, I'm copy the same thing, paste it, and just in, not in. Yeah. Tell me, guys, it returns true or false?
False.
PY not in A, but PY is also in A. So yeah, you are right. It returns false. Got it. But I am again run this statement and just type not in, and press enter. Yeah. Tell me, guys.
True.
So got it, guys. How the membership operation is work?
Sir, take uppercase of PY.
Yeah, uppercase of PY.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Like this or like this?
No, yes, sir. Like this.
In A. False. It's again the check the it's capital or lowercase. Okay. Got it?
Yeah, clear, sir.
Okay. So next is identity operator. Identity operators. Basically, identity operator is check the element is present in your entire string, or as well as check the data type. So now I'll give you example. Like is Python, and next is b equal to PY TH1. Okay, so enter, and yeah, so A is B. So guys, is true or false?
True.
Yeah. What about
true, sir?
True. Okay. But about others?
True, sir.
True. Okay. It false. Anyone have any idea how it is written false?
Yes, capital.
Oh, is capital.
Yes. Got spelling about it. Yeah. So I'm
capital letter.
Yeah. So because it's check the both things. Firstly, the check the every element capital. It's a capital form, it's a lower form, and it's again the check the data type of the particular element. Okay, for example, A equal to 1 2 3 4. It's a string, guys. I'm printing A, so it's a string. Okay, and again I'm creating next variable, like I think this variable name is same, abc. I'm creating another variable ACB equal to 1 2 3 4. Okay, and again and perform this is operator. So ABC is ACB. Yeah, guys, tell me.
False.
Yeah, returns false because the ABC is contain a string, but the ACB is contain a integer value. Okay. So I'm just type notice. So now it returns not. Okay. It returns true. All right, guys.
Yes, sir.
Now, so your all operators is finished till now. Okay, I'm completing this thing. So got it, guys, how the copy function is work in the string, sorry, list.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now let's go ahead and understand the next function is count.
So one sec.
Yeah.
How to append the element in middle of a list?
Okay, let's wait, and I am telling you how to add an element in the middle of the list and particular indexing. We want to add a new element in the middle of the list and any indexing. So it's a inbuilt function like insert. Insert method is available. Okay, so basically it is used to add an element at the specified position. Okay, so wait, I am performing every operation and every method. So now, the next function is count. The count function is basically used to
count a number.
Yeah, right. So it returns the number of elements with the specified.
Sir, small doubt, sir.
Yeah.
So, can we copy the list without a copy function? When directly we can assign BB equal to A without a copy function. Can you remove the copy function, sir?
Like this.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, it's working because AB is a list, but the ABs contain the list, but you assign the entire list into another variable. So now it's fine and it's also working.
So then no need to use copy function, right, sir?
But in some places it's mandatory to use a copy function.
Okay.
Yeah. So now let's see count. So again, I'm printing the list. Sorry. AB equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. I'm printing A. So I'm perform the count function. So A dot count. Sorry. Let's take one argument like I'm passing 1. Yeah, guys, tell me what the outcome coming from this statement A dot count.
Eleven.
No.
Two, sir. Two.
Two. Yeah, it's right. Sorry, must be string, not int. Okay.
Sir, it's triple A, I think.
Okay. Sorry. Yeah, it returns two. Okay. So next is and count. Tell me guys what is coming from this four. Yeah. Okay, so got it, guys, how the count functions work?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And next function is extend. And basically it is used to add the new element of the list to the end of the current. Got it, guys? The extend function is used to add the new element of a list to the end of the current list. So my current list is AAA. So I'm extend my list like this AAA dot end, and I'm passing list like 3, 4, 6, 7, and I print. So you see, the entire list is add the new element on the my current list. Okay. So one
sir,
question.
Sir, it won't print in the middle of the list.
Wait. I am coming in the insert option. Okay.
Sir, then what's the difference between FN and FN?
Yeah. So the question is, what is the difference between append and extend? Okay, so you see the append method, I am add a list. So you see it's the same as append the list, like it's a 2D list. Okay, so this is a 1D list and you see the nested list. Okay, you see. Okay, but in the extend method I am passing the same thing. Okay, I am passing the list, but in this thing, in this operation, we just add this element 3, 4, 56, 67, not a list. Okay, so got it? What is the difference between
extend
and append?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So next is index. Yeah, I am also covered in yesterday. So anyone guess how the index function work? Yeah, tell me. Yeah, guys. No one remember? It returns the index of the first element with a specified value. So my list is this. I perform the index operation. It's passing 1. You see it runs 0. So the index of 1 is 0. Got it? AA got perform like index and type 4. It returns 5. So I think one question coming in your mind. So this is a 5-4, like 1, 2, 3, 4. So how it returns only 5? Okay, because it returns the index of the first element. Okay, got it, guys? It returns the index of the first element. So it returns the 4 is available in this place. So the index of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so again, give the next example, index like 2, and again it returns 2, 0, 1. Got it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next is most important function is insert function. Basically, insert method is used to add element at a specified position. So it's used to add an element at the specified position. So again, my list is this, and I want to add a new element at a certain position. Okay. So like AAA dot index, sorry, insert. In this method, we have to pass the index as well as value. So I want to add a new element at this position 0, 1, 2, second position, okay? So I'm just passing the position like 2, and I want to add a string like Python. Press enter. You see, my element is added on the second index. So got it, guys? How to add an element as a certain position?
Yes, sir.
You know, another example, like I want to add a new element like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 index. And add like hello. You see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So hello is available on 5 index. So now your doubt is clear how to add a element at a certain position.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next function is pop.
Sir?
Yeah?
A of 2 equal to Python. Can we give like this to print the same answer?
Sorry, your voice is breaking.
A of 2 equal to Python.
2 can equal to Python?
Yes, sir. Can we give like this to print the same answer?
Like this, 2 equal to Python.
Not like that, sir. A of index 2 equal to Python.
A of... type in comment section.
Okay, sir.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can we insert a value before zero index?
No.
Okay, sir.
Because your indexing is starting from zero. A 2 equal to Python. Let's try. This is basically using indexing, and this is using inbuilt function. Yeah, ma'am. The doubt is clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next method is pop. So basically, pop method is used to remove the element at the specified position. Okay. Remove element at the specified. You see, not specified position and position. You see. Remove the element at the end of the list. So now 56 pop. So now my list is look like this. 56 is not element. So I am performing again this operation like pop. And you see the 4 is pop. And again I am printing. And you see the 4 is deleted from this list. So got it, guys? How the pop operation work? It remove the element to the end of the list. Hey guys. It's work. Now it's clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next method is reverse. Basically, it is. Order of the list. So I am printing my list. You see, it reverses the order of the list. Perform this operation reverse. Now you see the whole list is reversed. Listing is this position, but it did get like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. In this list, the listing is available on two indexing, but now the reverse listing, it available on 12th indexing. Okay, so it reverses your whole list. So got it, guys, how the reverse function is work?
Yes,
okay. So next is sort, which basically is used to sort your element. Sort the list. Now I'm creating a list A equal to 143 minus 1 0 5 100 like this. Now I'm performing the sort operation. It is and it returns. Returns, yeah, guys. It returns what?
Minus 1, 0, 1, 34, 45, 100.
Yeah, minus 1, 0, 1, 34, 35, 100. So it returns the sorting of the list in a appending order. Sorry, ascending order. So got it, guys? How the sort functions work and how to sort any element in the list. Yeah, guys.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So, guys, everything is clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So, if you have any doubt, then tell me. Otherwise, I'll be wind up the session.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can we sort the list in descending order?
Descending order?
Yes, sir.
Lot of methods like heap sort, bandit sort, merge sort, different methods. But it's an algorithm, okay, and not a simple.